Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to discuss the case study on the topic of FPGA development, that is how the FPGA development incorporated with the digital technologies. Here we are going to discuss about the company, that is Alpha Design Technologies. In this company, FPGA development is a major requirement. So we are discussing this FPGA development from this company requirement. In this topic, we are incorporating our design thinking stages one by one. We will discuss the topic one by one. So before enter into the topic, first we should know what is FPGA. That is, FPGA is a field programmable gate array or a semiconductor devices that are based around a matrix of configurable logic blocks connected via programmable interconnects. That is, FPGA can be reprogrammed to desired applications or functionality requirements after manufacturing. That is, where it is used, FPGA concept, that is, we are using, that is, video or imaging to circuitry for computer, audio, aerospace and military applications, in addition to electronics and specialized processing and more, we are using this FPGA. Then what is the purpose of this FPGA? That is, FPGA is an integrated circuit that can be customized for a specific application, that is in traditional part, that is the CPU. FPGA are field programmable. For this field programmable, we are using programmable array logic concept or programmable logic array concept. We are using this FPGA concept. Then the next question comes in our mind is, what is FPGA made of? That is, FPGA is most basic form of chip of CLB together. They make an FPGA. The many thousands of these that can be founded on modern FPGA can be programmed to perform virtually and logic functions. An individual CLB consists of a number of discrete logic components itself, that is lookup tables and flip-flops. We are combining all those, we are getting FPGA. So a single FPGA consists of more number of LUT, that is lookup table and flip-flops inside the FPGA. Then what is the major role of FPGA in VLSI? That is, the term FPGA stands for, we know that is a field programmable gate array. It is a type of semiconductor logic chip which can be programmed to become almost any kind of systems or digital circuits. We are using PLD, that is programmable logic devices, FPGA, or some of new trending area of in VLSI unit. Then next question comes into our mind is, that is, FPGA is faster than CPU. Yes, of course, that is well defined and well designed FPGA will always execute faster than software code running on a general purpose CPU chip. CPUs are generally more complex as compared to the FPGA, primarily because they already have a fixed set of internal blocks and process that are allowed being designed by the manufacturer unit. So next we are moving into our empathy part. That is, before enter into the empathy part, we are discussing the FPGA trend based on the market opportunities. That is, we are using field programmable gate array and field programmable array logic. It is the nanometer technology is vary from 2020 to 25. We are using CAGR of 7.6% in 2020 to 25. So our empathy part, we are analyzing our empathy part now. That is, how many times can we perform program in FPGA? That is, we can perform windowed EEPROM based devices at least 25 times. So it does not specify the number of times that you can reprogram or reconfigure FPGA devices, because these devices are static RAM based, because nowadays most of the electronic components we are using static RAM based concept. That is, SRAM based devices can be reprogrammed as often as based on the designer requirements, no specific limit. Then what is the design flow structure? Design flow structure, FPGA contains a two-dimensional array of logic blocks and interconnections between logic blocks. Both logic blocks and interconnects are programmable. Logic blocks are programmed to implement a desired function, and the interconnects are programmed using the switch boxes to connect the logic blocks. Immediately a question comes in our mind as FPGA is faster than GPU. Yes, of course, FPGA is a field programmable gateway that is based on the design requirement. We are designing a certain part of FPGA, so it is always better than a CPU, that is, or a GPU. That is, this GPU also communicate with the help of only CPU. So FPGA, it is feasible to get latency around below 1 microsecond, whereas CPU latency is more than 50 microseconds. So FPGA is more faster compared to the GPU unit. So next, why FPGA used in digital design? Means digital design, that is, FPGAs are prefabricated silicon chips that can be programmed electrically to implement the digital design. That is, we are using a static RAM concept in this FPGA digital design used for configuring both logic and interconnection using a stream of flip-flops and lookup tables with the help of lookup tables. That is based on the customer demand. If they are increasing the number of speed or increasing the size of the component, we are using we go with a different concept, that is static memory with the lookup table connection or dynamic memory with the flip-flop connection. Then why do we use this FPGA? Means that FPGA are also useful to business because they can be dynamically reprogrammed with a data path that exactly matches a specific workload, that is data analytics, image interference, encryption and compression. These are all the different areas we are using FPGA technology. Then optimized FPGA are also more power efficient than running equivalent workload on CPU. So our empathy part, we are using FPGA concept and data analytics, image references, encryption, decryption, and then digitization. So our empathy part is characterized into different categories. So our define stage, we are focusing only our digitization concept. For this digitization concept, we have to identify the FPGA configuration, node size and technology is the major thing. So based on the configuration, it is classified into three types, that is lower end FPGA and mid-range FPGA and high end FPGA. That is based on the application and based on the demand, we are categorizing this FPGA into three different modes, that is lower end, mid end and high end. And node size, that is, nowadays nanometer technology plays a vital role in VLSI domain. That is node size, we are choosing three sizes, that is less than 28 nanometer, and second one is 28 to 90 nanometer, and third one is more than 90 nanometer. And we are focusing the technology is static RAM, that is SRAM, and flash unit and anti-fuse unit. That is we can reprogram many times in FPGA if you are using the static RAM concept. That's why in FPGA design, static RAM plays a vital role for FPGA designing concept. So this is our defined part. In defined part, we have to discuss one more concept, that is vertical. We are using FPGA with static RAM in different verticals, that is telecommunication, consumer electronics. That is, consumer electronics is our defined part. test measurement and emulation. For if we using telecommunication means field programmable gate array is it is a semiconductor. So FPGA allows system designer to use silicon based devices instead of merchant silicon. So the latest FPGA versions support high speed serial LANs up to 32 gigabytes per second and integrate hard IP for 100 gigahertz Ethernet. So the speed rate in telecommunication, it is keep on increased with the help of FPGA designed using serial LAN communication. And second one is consumer electronics. In consumer electronics, that is medical imaging process, a growth opportunity because FPGA offering a high degree of flexibility or reprogrammable and reusable. However, ASIC as design based FPGA substitutes growth over the in upcoming next six years, according to the report of analysis. That is, the field programmable gate array have become commonplace on signal processing board for defense applications, such as we are using radar and solar unit. We are using this FPGA concept. So the device promises even more capability down to the road, especially in communication technology such as software defined radio and multimedia, healthcare, broadcasting, and all the areas in all the verticals we are using this FPGA with the static RAM concept. So that is our defined part. So in our defined part, we are focusing only the second vertical, that is consumer electronics unit. In consumer electronic unit, for this consumer electronic, we are offering solution in our ideate part. That is, in nowadays we are using a digital set of boxes in our TV unit, that is digital set of box receive and decode the television broadcast from satellite, cable or terrestrial sources. Integrated digital television have a built-in digital tuners, demodulators and source decoders. So they do not require digital set of box that receive digital broadcast. Traditional digital set of box are designed to receive standard definition moving pictures, that is MPEG-2 video format broadcast. However, many of today digital set of box are high definition ready. That is, we have to select a cable television services provider, networkers and local terrestrial TV stations are concurrently transmitting both SD and HD content. For this transmission, we are using this FPGA concept, that is in MPEG-4 becomes the standard compression standards system implementation, reconfigurable logic devices, that is FPGA will be able to upgrade without having to scrap inventory items or make new hardware. Using this FPGA, manufacturer can design the set of boxes that can be decoded MPEG-2 video format and lesser than upgrade that same STP for MPEG-4 by simply reprogramming and the FPGA in system. So we can easily convert MPEG-2 to MPEG-4 with a normal reprogramming concept. We using FPGA, we are offering high quality, that is high definition images in our set of box, that is high end DSTB usually, that is offer provisional video recorders and high definition DVD recorders for Blu-ray functions. Microcontrollers or integrated DTV can perform a number of functions of these systems, including control panel and control panel management and on-screen display. Then many current digital set of boxes can be classified either as free to air or paid TV versions. A paid TV example would be a digital set of boxes designed for the direct TV or dish network which require conditional access to decode the audio and video. That is, if you are using this field programmable, there is no conditional access required for decoding and audio video functions. The digital set of box manufacturers typically design the PCB for both low end and high end digital set of boxes systems and require a flexible solution for implementing their various design. The figure that is the FPGA structure shows the how to convert, that is MPEG-4 to MPEG-2 to MPEG-4 and video and audio conversion with the static RAM concept and lookup table concept we are implementing in our IDEA part. That is how the pixel rate is, that is 1080 into 9550, how it is converted with the help of field programmable gate array. That is our IDEA part, and we are discussing our prototype. So we are taking the prototype example as digital signal player. It is a small and physical device that renders, that is, it is in TV monitor or digital display. It is a crucial part of digital signal systems and a device it uses across a variety of different industries and use cases. It is mainly used in security purpose. That is, security is the another key feature that we should consider when selecting our player. That is authentication and digital signal industry. It is plays a vital role in the digital signage player. If hackers again access our digital signals player, they can force a player to display embarrassing and important content. Additionally, hackers can exploit hardware and to access private information. Immediately, the FPGA unit static RAM informations are deleted or corrupted, so we can't able to view the information from the digital signage player. So it in security systems, the FPGA with the static RAM plays a vital role. So we are discussing this as our prototype, and next move on to our testing part. That is, in our testing part, the integrated FPGA modules which are powered independently captured and display the last video frame. In case of any system malfunction, we can easily identify the last video frame also. The system also has iBase unique iSmart energy harvesting technology, so that enables power on off scheduling and power resume function. So FPGA using static RAM plays a vital role in our consumer electronic unit. So far we have discussed our FPGA concept and what are all our empathy part. From this empathy, we have our defined state. That is, in our defined state is we are focusing only consumer electronics. So for this consumer electronics based on FPGA, we are offering solution in our IDEA part. That is our how the static RAM with FPGA used to find a solution with the lookup tables, and we are discussing one our prototype, that is digital signage player. In digital signage player, that is how the security systems plays a vital role in with the help of FPGA unit. And last one is our testing part. That is how we are captured our last video frame, if any information lost or power consumption we have discussed so far. So I think all the students got clear information about FPGA implemented in digital electronics. Thank you.